The risks in the insurance industry are changing all the time, but so too are the ways companies are addressing them. Aon's James Platt spoke to Silicon Republic about how tech is changing the insurance industry. So what are some of the big risks in insurance and how is tech being used to address them?
The big risks that are really emerging are probably the ones that are most interesting. And these are risks around things like climate, things around pandemic, which for us is supply chain, and areas like cyber. And what's interesting about these new big risks that are occurring is that our traditional methods for really understanding risk, which was time and, you know, looking at a risk historically, like for property, really don't work because the risks are so new. So what's happening in the background is our teams are working to do really two things. One is to collect the data that they need for those risks. And then the second is to start modeling that in ways that insurers or capital providers will feel confident to put their money behind people's risks. So those two are the ways that tech is helping. And if you imagine for something like climate, that's a huge amount of data that we have to collect in different areas so that people feel confident. And in terms of the modeling, these models are new. We're using the latest modeling techniques. We're building new ways of thinking about it. As I say, in the second that somebody feels confident to put their money behind it, you know you've got there. But there's a huge amount of work going on based around tech.
And then separate from the risks themselves, how can tech be used to help the underserved in the insurance industry?
There's a lot of different groups of underserved in our industry. Maybe just sort of picking on one and using one example as I work my way through would be we have a lot of people out there who want better health cover, better health protection, and we work a lot to provide that. And you see a number of problems. So maybe the first one is education. You know, what do I actually need? The second is around product. So what's the best product for me to cover those needs that I have? And then the third is, how do we get those products and distribute them to that individual cheaply enough that they can actually afford the product? And tech can help on all three. So on the first, when it really comes to education, we can use things like benchmarking comparisons in the same way that many of the tech firms, like when you go on to Netflix or Amazon today, we can do that with health protection, which is really, really quite cool and quite interesting. When it comes to product matching, we're beginning to build algorithms which search thousands of products and work out the best solution for an individual. And again, that takes pretty advanced and complicated modeling given the amount of products and different people's needs. And then lastly, on distribution, trying to distribute digitally is great, but trying to do it on the internet means that, frankly, all the money and a lot of cost in trying to compete with search terms. So we're trying to embed a lot of our products and thinking with partners. That's a much more efficient way to get there. How do people get it in their everyday world? Or lastly, how do we build things like exchanges, which are inherently efficient to get things so that people can afford them? So tech's got a role to play everywhere in sort of getting insurance to the underserved.
Thanks very much, James.
Thanks, Jenny.